lot of ammo left. Ugh. Nero Beacon. Okay, where is it? Yeah, not bad. Meat. So help. Okay. An injector. Nero had all the good shit. Ow. Feeling stronger already.
How many runs has this been? God, I'm tired. Yeah, I know, right? I'm right there with you. It's too goddamn many. Lost count.
You check the manifest? Where's the next load going, huh?
It's over at the Iron Butte Ranch. They started a new dig site just outside the resort there.
That must have made those rich assholes happy. I wonder how much a house on the ninth hole is worth now that it backs up to a mass grave, huh?
Yeah, I know, right? What the hell?
What are they doing?
Jesus! Break! Break!
Oh no! We're gonna hit him! No!
I guess you boys never made it back to fill that manifest, did you? Well, didn't matter. There was a hell of a lot more where they came from. Always need this. Ugh. Fix this. Let's go. Yeah. Oh. Need this? I got a use for you. Doesn't look too bad. Can of fuel. Needed this. Shit, almost out. Fresh meat. Okay. scrap. I gotta burn them out. I gotta make it safer to ride. Okay. Yeah! Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
Got it.
Now I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to. Get in there.
Loser! Loserman, are you listening? You're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
go check him out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet. If they see me,
I heard it.
Throw a rock, that ought to distract them. Stay in the shrubs, they can't see me in there.
Now,
or we will open fire.
What
the hell are we doing here?
Got plenty of fuel. I double checked. Flew over farewell. That was a lot of goddamn freakers.
Yeah.
I don't want any trouble.
Shifter, we will open fire!
To be friends now, can't we?
Immediately!
Okay, that ought to distract them.
How long this will take?
2 days. That's how long.
Tell me this is.
I'll get back. Going all over hell and back today.
But you police robots were all around, staying focused.
Jesus, this is taking forever.
I don't think forever's a long time.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
So nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Didn't you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
Civilian, I am not going to ask you again.
Leave him.
Subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
It's been nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
There's someone in my series. No.
I asked if you could help get people. Say
stay in the shrubs.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors of the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeing. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Seal the caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Something.
Something moved over there.
Okay, stay low.
Civilian, I am not going to ask you again.
We could be friends now, can't we? Stay low. We could be friends now, can't we?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Hey, I'm here.
When we rode out of farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Hey, he's alive, loser. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen. I heard on the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Set you free. The start of this living hell is now our life. Came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know. Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe our lies.
How's that, huh?
Now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they'd have blown it to hell. Just so we wouldn't have to...
That's what you get.
Shit.
now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio 4. This is Mark Corcoran for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Hello, Squatter Cat.
Some things never change.
use this.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families.
Please, son.
I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself. And last I checked, there were plenty of assholes out here trying to take what's rightfully ours. Okay. Finally. Jesus. Oh, here we go. That should be it.
Good night.
Okay. Use everything. This man I'm tracking down. Who'd he kill?
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them was a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Now.
Still got.
There he is! Silver helmet. Red gas tank. That's it.
Oh, shit! The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, and just ride out like you were just shopping at the mall.
Go to hell, Drifter! Copeland can suck on it, you hear me?
Freeze!
Huh.
If you want to know the truth, give Drifters a bad name. What if you'd shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You are a Copeland's toadies! You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Nope, it's done. Got him. Mark down these coordinates and send your men out here.
You hear me?
Is he alive?
Yeah, he's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's gonna stay that way. Deacon out. Boozer, you there? I was just calling to check up on you.
Yeah, Deacon, up here.
Hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said. Just work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out.
One upgrade coming up. All right.
All right. Deacon, keep an eye on that gas tank. What was the custom paint job you're asking about?
Manny, I'm still not happy with you.
That should last you for a while. Good choice, man. Good choice. Oh, yeah, that's a good piece.
We don't have the tools here. No. I mean,
I'll wrap that up for you. Cool. Need anything else? This should last you for a while.
Where do I start?
This girl could use a tune-up. Yep, always needing fuel. Drifter life. Thanks, man.
Hey,
just looking.
Something. You got something to say about it?
What? Hey. Not enough credits?
Okay, see ya. That's all I got today.
Deacon.
What's going on?
There's never enough wood on this fire.
What do you need?
Damon.
This is Radio Free Oricon. The truth shall set you free. Broke another goddamn razor this morning. In our supposed global utopia, instead of getting the best products from around the world, we got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out.
Let's see what we got in here.
Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the new this and that. All to feed the beast of crass commercialism. You want something built to last? You couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country, they'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. And neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oricon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope, but hey, what do you say? Nothing wrong with a little crass commercial. I mean, I could use a new bike. But... it, ambush, ambush.
Bring him down! Yeah, keep on running around.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Back during the American Revolution, when we were fighting for our freedoms, we gained the beautiful right to keep and bear arms. A right we use to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That is, until the ever-growing federal government got scared of the people they swore to protect. Over the years, they stripped us of every gun right they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control. And there went the Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. when all this shit went down, if every American was packing heat, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. But this is how the feds wanted it. Disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all. So who did those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this? I want to take a poll. I bet those who survived were those who had guns. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get my hands on. Ain't no one taking them away from me.
Oh,
Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit! You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Well, except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
Someone's trapped. I gotta help.
Hey, it's okay. Hey, it's not safe out here in the shit. I know where there's a camp that...
A camp? Yeah, where? I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you.
Tell him it was Deacon. They'll know. Now just keep running, stay off the roads.
Yeah.